Good afternoon, everybody. Welcome to our winter concert. Wait, no, it's not winter. For those of you on the live stream, it's snowing here, and it seems like winter now. So, welcome to our fall concert. That was my poor attempt at a joke. It's really great to see you all here this afternoon at our auditorium. So thank you for being here. The first tune that you heard today was Switch in Time, written by the legendary jazz composer Sammy Nestico. Sammy wrote that for the first collaboration between him and Count Basie, and that was on the album Basie Straight Ahead, one of Count Basie's most well-known and well-respected albums. And you heard great section playing, a lot of soulful playing within that. And I'd like to have another round of applause for trombonist Emily Lamarck on his solo, soloing on that one. Next, we're going to get to one of Thelonious Monk's charts. Actually, it was probably his most recorded chart. Thelonious Monk, piano player of the bebop time period, recorded a great deal of albums. Many of them were live as well, and on almost all of those live albums, you'll hear this next tune, which is titled Blue Monk. Very neat piece. And you're going to hear a lot of solos within that one as well. So we hope you enjoy Blue Monk. Thank you. Thank you. let's have another round of applause for a soloist on that one. You heard Jack Promotion on tenor sax. Good job, Jack. Dalton Stoops, trumpet. And back on the drum set, you heard Stephen Cave. Good job. Okay, Thelonious Monk, back in the early 40s, was hanging out at this place, this club in New York City called Minton's Playhouse. And that became a place that a lot of young swing musicians would hang out, and every chance they weren't playing in a big band during the 40s, which was a lot of people were playing swing in the 40s, they would hang out at Minton's. And the reason that place was special is because they could experiment with things. Within the swing time period, everybody wanted to dance and everybody wanted to hear the same music so they could dance to that same music. And that made these young musicians like Thelonious Monk and the person we're going to talk about and you're going to hear next, it made them a little unhappy. They felt their artistic freedom was being limited. So they went to Minton's, and the cool thing is that something new came out of that, and that was bebop. One of the people that went to Minton's was Thelonious Monk, as I mentioned, but on trumpet, there was this guy named Dizzy Gillespie. And he was experimenting with new harmonies. He's creating new chords and a new harmonic language, which then went on to become the harmonic language of bebop. And we're going to play you one of his pieces right now. It's called Burke's Work. Burke's Works. And he uses his real name. His real name is John Burke's Gillespie. So this is an arrangement of Burke's Works. Thank you. All right. So with on that, I'd like to give another round of applause to Jack Promotion. And Dalton Stoops on trumpet. We're going to highlight another monster composer within the jazz realm, and that is the great Duke Ellington on this next piece. Duke, in 1947, he wrote and composed many charts, a few charts, and put them together into this album called The Liberian Suite. And it's on the very first chart of that is what we're going to hear next. It's called I Like the Sunrise. And after that, there are a few dances that you hear within that suite. And the cool thing about Duke Ellington is he was constantly revamping his work. So you could hear the same chart, and it can be different each time you hear it. And that's true within this one. If you go to that Liberian suite and listen to the first chart, I Like the Sunrise, you may be shocked to hear that it's the same piece until you hear the vocalist come in. Then you'll immediately recognize it. But that's what's really neat about Duke Ellington and his music. He also had this amazing arranger that worked with him named Billy Strayhorn. And Billy Strayhorn arranged the music you're going to hear right now. And this was recorded, this version was recorded by Ella Fitzgerald and Duke Ellington himself in 1965, you know, about 18 years after this piece originated. Other renditions of this, you can hear Frank Sinatra. He has a pretty famous version of this as well. So to sing this with us, we're going to welcome Michaela Danko to the stage. So please welcome Maggie Danko.
Thank you.
Wow, how about another round of applause? Come on back out here. Next up, we're going to feature a piece by Benny Golson. Yes, Benny Golson, called Along Came Betty. And Benny Golson got his mark working with people like Dizzy Gillespie, Lionel Hampton. He was a tenor saxophonist, but he eventually became more known as someone who was really writing exceptional music. If you have been watching our jazz ensemble concerts in the past, you may have heard some other standards of his. Last year, in the spring, we did I Remember Clifford. That was written by Benny Golson. And here we have another standard. And really, the story about this is Benny Golson was dating a girl named Betty, and it inspired him to write a song. So here is Along Came Betty. Thank you. jump back into another Thelonious Monk piece, but this time he had help with a tenor saxophonist that was, really came to popularity in the swing era in the 30s, and that was Coleman Hawkins. So Coleman Hawkins was one of those people that bridged the gap between swing and bebop, and he was actually the first instrumentalist that released a bebop album. Because at that point in time, as bebop was being created, there was actually an AFM strike and instrumentalists weren't releasing albums. So Coleman Hawkins was one of the first bebop artists to share a record with the world. So this is I Mean You, one of their joint pieces, and it was recorded by Coleman Hawkins, 1946, and then 2 years later, Monk then recorded it as well. Our arrangement is unique in that you're gonna hear it's arranged in a way that has a second line feel. And what that means is in New Orleans, whenever jazz was created, one of the first true forms of jazz was Dixieland music. And there was a first line and a second line. And so sometimes you'll hear Dixieland referred to as second line style. So you'll hear that here in this piece. And it also goes back and forth between that style and traditional swing. So this is our unique arrangement of I Mean You by Coleman Hawkins and Thelonious Monk. Thank you. But we are now going to play something by a contemporary composer, and that is Chris Sharp. And Chris Sharp is a great young writer here, and we love his music. We use some of his music for our warm-ups and jazz ensemble, and it's just great. And this one is a samba tune called Gimme Samba That, and you're going to hear some very creative, melodic aspects of this, instruments passing melodies back and forth. And here's a modern samba by Chris Sharp, Gimme Samba That. Okay, on that piece we heard Dalton Stoops again on trumpet, David Smith, alto saxophone, and now back to the jazz history lesson. So the next piece is by Horace Silver, and he was composing, you know, in that same time period as we were talking about, you know, Dizzy Gillespie, Benny Golson. He was composing around that same time period. And one of the people that Horace Silver worked with was Art Blakey and the Jazz Messengers. He and Art Blakey formed that group. And then Horace went his separate way and did his own thing. And this piece you're going to hear, Filthy McNasty, is one of his more well-known tunes. And it came out of his small jazz chamber group, his Combo, based upon the blues. So we're going to feature a lot of instrumentalists within this one. You're going to hear six different soloists. It's one where you just get to really groove and have fun. And within that, there's a quartet that you're going to hear. And the quartet will have what? Alto sax, trombone, trumpet, and the vibraphone. So please excuse me while I take this microphone over to the vibraphone. Thank you. All right. Soloists on that piece were aplenty. So let me see if I can remember all of you. So Charlie Lasella, trumpet. Ben Koski, bass trombone. And David Smith, alto saxophone. Tanner Smith, trombone. Ian Herr, vibraphone. And Emily Lamarck on trombone. Oh, your hand's tired yet. So before our last piece, I want to acknowledge someone who's graduating in December and has done great work within the jazz ensemble, and we really loved having him here. And that is someone who just said his name, Ben Petoskey. Can you stand up? We appreciate everything you've done. Thank you, Ben. And I would like to invite you all to other School of Music events that we're going to be having here in the coming weeks. Starting next Saturday, we're going to have Brass Extravaganza next Saturday. And there are two events, there are a lot of events within that day. It's a day that has master classes and performances, but let's say you just want to hear a performance. There are two of those right here in OR Auditorium, the first being the Faculty Brass Quintet. That's at noon on OR stage here. Then our guest artist for that day is Sergeant First Class J.G. Miller. He's the principal horn of the U.S. Army Field Band. He's going to be giving an incredible recital, just good stuff that he wrote. Most of it is actually his own work. Very engaging work. That'll be here on OR stage as well. Next Sunday at 3 p.m. in the chapel, you don't want to miss the choirs, the Westminster College choirs. So that's just in the next week, and I'll let you look at the back of the program there for other events that are upcoming. Okay, so once again, we thank you for coming out this afternoon. We hope to see you back next semester for our winter concert and our spring concert as well. And we're gonna finish with Chris Berg's Feather Report. Every year, Chris Berg seems to write something that has to do with birds, like the chicken or something that has to do with birds. And this is his Feather Report. It may sound like a band, you know, from the jazz fusion time period called the Weather Report. And if you're like, hey, that sounds like Weather Report, that was purposeful. Chris really loves Weather Report. So within this, if you know their tunes like Birdland, you'll hear quotes from that. And there are other quotes as well. So listen for that within here. And once again, thank you for coming out.